Hello friends, welcome to Dr. Ajay Sharma's YouTube channel, and in this video we are going to discuss, tell me, can you guess? Yes, your guess is 100% right. That is nature of emotions. The emotions are, I'll tell you one thing, the ornaments of our behavior. Our behavior is being made beautiful, and its expressions and the activities, all which comes under the behavior, are beautified by the entry of emotions. So without discussing this point so early, we'll be moving step by step. We'll start with the meaning of emotions, then we'll go with the definition of the emotions, then a little bit of brief introduction of the emotions, and what are the physiological basis of emotions. And one more important thing we'll discuss in this video will be, what are the brain parts that contribute in manifesting and experiencing the emotions. So at the start of this video I told you, emotions are, yes, it's ornaments. If you wear better ornaments, your posture, your look will be beautiful and attractive. Similar case with the emotions. So we are not worried about what type of emotions you wear. Our main point is, what is the nature of emotions, how they are produced, why they are produced, and what is their use in our human life. So without discussing further, let us go to the slides and start our today's discussion, that is known as nature of emotions. Friends, let us move to the discussion, that is nature of emotions. This video you are seeing is of very image is very famous in the recent past in Indian context. Chandrayaan 2 was launched on 27th July, and dear friends, it was a 98% success, but when it fails to achieve its 100% success, the person who was responsible for this big project, a proud moment project for India, was Professor K. Sivan, the chief of ISRO. He is that gentleman. When that Vikram lander fails to communicate with the ground stations, and the Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi, was at ISRO center at that point, and when he say goodbye to that ISRO chief, that time, that emotions, the hard work of last 10 years, that came out, and in the form of small water drops, we generally call as tears. Prime Minister Narendra Modi, a dynamic personality, hugged that individual and consoled. And as Kumar Viswas said, the shoulder offered by Prime Minister Modi was not of Prime Minister, but it was the shoulder of 130 crore Indians. Means we Indians are proud of our ISRO, her achievements, and the scientists, engineers, and administrators all working in ISRO, so we salute them. So what is the purpose of showing this image here is the emotions. Who says the scientists are not emotional? You can just, this image is a brief and proof that scientists too have heart and they are emotional too. So let's move to the our next slide. That is meaning of emotions. The word emotion is derived from French word émouvoir, which means to stir, means to move out. The emotions are frequently interchangeably used with mood and feelings. So, but all these three, that emotions, mood and feelings, are different entities. What is the mood? Affective state of long duration, and lesser intense than emotions. So this is known as mood. What is the feelings? Feelings means pleasure and pain, dimension of emotions with physical changes. In fact, emotions contains both these phenomena. I'll let you know one thing. Define, what is mood? Mood is a part of emotions. But there is one fundamental difference between mood and emotions is, in the point of view of mood, the feelings are of lesser intensity, but they stay for longer period. Say, suppose if you are happy, you will be happy for longer period, but the intensity of your happiness will be not as strong as during your emotional experience. Similar to the case with the feelings, when you experience emotions, we sometimes feel pleasure, we sometimes feel pain. These dimensions, pleasure and pain dimensions of emotions, is known as your feelings. In fact, mood and feelings are the subset of emotions. This means these both make up together or component or part of emotions. I think it's clear to you. Now let's move to the definition. Various organizations, institutes, psychologists or neurologists, they have defined emotions in various terms, but the three important definitions I have chosen for you. That first one is taken from the NCRT. The complex pattern of changes in response to situation perceived as personally significant, including physiological arousal, feelings, thoughts and behaviors. So one thing here important is, it's a complex pattern of changes in human body, that is internal as well as external changes. By virtue of emotion or the situation which is personally significant, that is, and they feel, and the thoughts and behaviors. So this is due to your some feeling of emotions. So emotions are a complex set of behavior. Then Baron defines emotions as the reactions consisting of subjective cognitive states, physiological reactions and expressive behaviors. So here also he defines emotions as cognitive states. In this case, physiological reactions to cognitive states means experiencing the emotions, and physiological reactions, that is arousal, what the bodily changes which goes inside the body, and expressive behaviors, what that bodily changes led to a behavior which is observable. Getting my point? So that is by Baron and the Australian Mayer in 2016. They say the feeling aspect of consciousness characterized by a certain physical arousal, a certain behavior that reveals the emotion to the outside world, and an inner awareness of feelings. So these are more or less the definitions are almost similar. And what is the important point in all this definition is, that is physiological arousal, expressive behavior and feelings, and it's a cognitive state. So these are the definition. You can remember, you can read, and you can understand the concept of emotions through these definitions. Then comes your introduction. So dear friends, emotions are the cognitive ornament of human behavior, which I told you earlier, that without this ornament, our behavior is not as beautiful or as interesting or as lovely as it is. So emotions are ornament and they beautify our behavior. Emotions give appropriate meaning to behavior, which is manifested through physical actions. So without emotions, we cannot decide the intensity and the intention of behavior. The original role of emotions was to motivate adaptive behavior that in the past would have contributed to the passing on to genes through survival, reproduction and kin selection. So this is, I take on this from the Wikipedia, dear friends. So that was the original role of emotions, how we select our kin, what's our relationships, and this way how we survive. These are the basic role of, you call it as a basic or fundamental role of emotions. Emotions also do have close relationship with experience. Yes, experience is a part of, you call it a cognitive state, but it's closely relates with the emotions. What is experience? A subjective conscious state of being. What you feel and what you carry and what you store in your memory, and that is subjective. Because subjective means no one other than the individual experiencing something can know and can experience in the same intensity or with same quantity or same quality or same brightness or anything you know, you can say that. So the direction of experience, whether positive or negative, is defined by none other than emotions. What your experience will be, whether it will be positive or it will be negative, that is the role of that labeling your experience is done by the emotions. So in essence, emotions are specific subjective responses to external or internal stimuli in context of psychosocio-biological environment. This definition, I tried to devise this and tried my best to inculcate and include almost maximum possible things which are related to emotions. Dear friends, here I didn't use the physiological arousal. Arousal is a part, but I want to say emotions are specific subjective responses to external or internal stimuli in context of psychosocio-biological environment. Then we will move into our main discussion, that is nature. First, you must understand that emotions are multimodal states that result from the joint and simultaneous action of various psychobiosocial components. So emotions, when we feel emotions, when we experience emotions, that we cannot do. We can't do with simple one phenomena, or it is not a stepwise phenomena. It is a simultaneous phenomena, and it is a joint action of various aspects, various contexts that comes under the psychobiological and sociological domains. The emotions are explained by various psychologists and neurologists from different perspectives, but have the three things in common in their explanation. What are that? Physiology of emotions means what are the internal body changes which we can experience but we cannot see. The second is expression of emotions, that is external bodily changes we can experience as well as we can see. I'll discuss internal, I'll let you know. And the third is experience of emotions. This is the cognitive aspect, these are the cognitive changes. So emotions are dynamic phenomena that are manifested with different intensities. It is situation specific, stimulus specific. You cannot say with certainty that yesterday I heard a joke and I laughed with that. Today also I laugh with the same intensity. That depends upon your stimuli, your present state of being, your context, social context, your cultural context. So it's a very, very subjective as well as very dynamic phenomenon. Emotions are dynamic. You cannot say and with your certainty that you will feel, you will experience with the same, similar stimuli with similar intensity. So this is a very dynamic one. And it is manifested. It means expressive behavior. So what are the internal body changes? You see blood pressure rises, your heartbeat rises, your mouth may dry up, your pupils may dilate. So these are the internal. We can experience, but we cannot see. We cannot perceive. Second comes is the external body changes, perspiration. Your muscle get tense. If people start crying, there are tears in their eyes. So these are external body changes during emotions. So there may be different large number of changes we'll be discussing in the next video. So let's move to the next. The individual and situational factors influence the expressions of emotions. Yes, it's a very clear-cut phenomena. So what are the individual factors? Your gender, personality type, psychopathology, social role. These are your individual factors. So gender means, I let you know, all emotions. That's in the previous slide, we have discussed, in this slide we'll be discussing and we'll be telling this how gender influences the emotions. Personality type also extrovert, introvert, or some ambivert and all. And psychopathology, if individual suffering from some disorder, mental disorder, that time also the expressions and feeling of emotions will be little bit of different. Similarly, the social role. So what are the situation factors? Presence of others. When you are in the presence of others, people around you, when you are a group, so that time also the expression and experience of emotions will be almost different. It will be significantly affected by the presence of others, people, social situations or cultural situations and cultural gathering, etc., etc. These are the situational factors, and in which situation you are, these significantly affect the expression of emotions. So at least 6 basic emotions are experienced and recognized across the globe. So what are these? There is lots of people. Izzard has said that there are 10 emotions. Plutchik has said there are 8 emotions. He combined these, make in the 4 pairs of emotions. So there are different people, different emotions. But globally, there are 6 emotions which are recognized and universally recognized and experienced. That is anger. You can see with the smiley, when we are angry, our face tend to be, our lips in this way curved downward. Then if you are disgust, then comes the fear. This is your fear. Then comes your happiness or the joy. Then comes your sadness. And then comes last is a surprise. These are the 6 basic emotions which are experienced and recognized across the globe. So this is another picture. Which is as taken from Very Well Mind website. So these emotions here in this picture, the emotions are expressed through behavior, not the face expression. This is through behavior. When you are happy, you will do like that. Sad people may sometime behave this way. Similarly, the case of fear, surprise, anger, and disgust. They're good image. So research indicate that. Women, why that in the last previous slide I told you, you can see the previous slide, that gender is your individual factor that influences the expressions of emotions. So here, I'll let you know how gender influences the experience of emotions. See, research indicate that women experience all the emotions except anger more intensely than men. Men experience anger with higher intensity and frequency. That may be why it is so. Why it is so? But psychologists, sociologists, various anthropologists, researchers tried to find the answer, and they come to the conclusion that the gender difference in expression and experience of emotion is due to differential social roles. Because social roles are different. Why they are different? Because the men or the male people have to behave, have a role of competitiveness. They are competitive. Whereas women are found to be affiliating and more caring. They have more affiliation, more caring. So that way, all 5 emotions, that is your happiness, sadness, fear, disgust, and surprise, are experienced by women more intensely, except anger. And frequency of experiencing of anger in men is more than women, including intensity too. So let's move to the next. Physiological basis of emotions. When we experience emotions, a stream of physiological changes such as increased heart rate, I told you, breathing rate, perspiration, trembling of limbs, etc., take place inside our body, including outside our body. Emotional experience is a result of various neurophysiological activations, in which what part plays role? Thalamus. This is the location of your thalamus. This is thalamus. This is your hypothalamus. Limbic system, this whole green part is known as limbic system. Cerebral cortex and amygdala. So these are the neurophysiological organs of, that is your parts of your brain that play important role in the feeling and expressions of our emotions. So what these parts, brain parts, do, or what is their role, what actually they are? Thalamus is generally known as relay center of sensory nerves. Stimulation of it produces fear and anxiety. If you stimulate the thalamus, an individual will experience fear and anxiety. The second is hypothalamus, which is the primary center for regulation of emotions. Then comes the limbic system. In limbic system, in fact, is made up of thalamus and hypothalamus also. It also includes these two parts. So, in association with these, thalamus and hypothalamus, it plays important role in regulation of emotions. Then comes the amygdala. It is responsible for emotional control and formation of emotional memories. Here it needs a little bit of explanation. Suppose you are very happy, you scored almost 98 or 99% marks in psychology annual examination. That memory you will remember always. That experience, that feeling you will remember always. But who stored that memory? That memory, yes, you are right, that memory is stored by the amygdala. So whenever you have similar achievement or similar experience of happiness, that time that memory will come to the fore, and for that who is responsible? Amygdala. Getting my point? Means emotions related memory is stored by the amygdala. Then the last part is cerebral cortex, the left frontal cortex. So suppose this is you take it as your brain, and individual is facing this way. This is your left part, this is your right part. So the left frontal cortex, this is your left frontal cortex, is associated with positive emotions, while right frontal cortex is associated with your negative emotions. So this is right with the colorful part. So now you know. So next time if you feel a negative emotions or something, sadness or anger or fear, then you can aware, and you are now you know that which part of brain is responsible for that. That is your right frontal cortex. Getting my point? And you feel happy, joy, surprise, and start jumping. That is the handiwork of your left frontal cortex. So it is a very, very clear. People will say the individual is not good from the heart. His is a looking good, but his may not be. He's not good from inside. What that means? That people are labeling that individual, and on the basis of her or his behavior or his frequent expressions of emotions, they, on that basis of that, individual characterize an individual as a good or bad, and you know which part is responsible for which type of emotions. And finally, the physiological changes are accelerated by the sympathetic nervous system. We have autonomic nervous system, that two parts of that, that is sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system. So when we feel when we are in a situation, or when you have stimuli, in that case, that are physiological changes or physiological arousal which is take inside the our body, that is accelerated by the sympathetic nervous system. So next time if you are very happy and you found that your heart rate has increased, your respiration rate has increased, and for that, who is responsible? Sympathetic nervous system is responsible. And it is that heightened state of arousal we reach due to the sympathetic nervous system. And that heightened state of arousal is brought back to normalcy by parasympathetic nervous system. So after experiencing emotions, labeling occurs. When we experience some emotions, labeling occurs. Labeling in that, amygdala plays an important role, because that memory of that emotions is stored in the amygdala. So the labeling occurs. And what is labeling? Labeling means giving a name to a particular facial expression in context of culture, social situation and geographical location, etc., etc. So giving a name to a particular emotion, this is known as cognitive aspect of emotions, because it involves recalling from memory and matching with similar previous experience which I had described you, that is done with the help of amygdala. So dear friends, this was our nature of emotions, and these are my references. You can always cross check them, and you can, for deeper study or for more study, you can refer them. So our next video will be bodily changing during the emotions. So dear friends, by the time If you have any doubt or you want to say something or you want to write some comment, you can write in my the comment box or you can email me at varmasujit@yahoo.com. Dear friends, here I want to tell you one thing. Your critical comments are always invited because your critical comments improve the videos, quality of videos. And one thing, I am thankful to my all friends who are regularly expressing their views through in the comment box. Still, if you feel that it is a good platform, you can write through my email. I'll be happy to receive your comments. If you like this video, dear friends, share with your friends or those who are preparing for psychological exam, or sometimes you can share with your teachers. But if you dislike it, certainly share what part and why you dislike it, so that I not ask for the question to you. Only point is, I'll improve in the next video. Dear friends, by that time, thank you for watching this video from core of my heart.